Welcome back, my friends. So thank you guys so much for trying out CalVPN, the alpha, the free alpha. Means the world to me. So a bunch of people have signed up, they've been testing it out, they've been sending in feedback, and even some have found some bugs, and some really embarrassing bugs. So thank you guys for doing that. You're basically part of the team now. And if you're new around here, I basically just created this post-quantum VPN, a new kind of VPN that can theoretically protect you from quantum computers. So if you want to read more into that and what the hell, why that's important, go check out the website in the description. You can download the free VPN. You can use it for free. And then the beta, hopefully, is coming in a month. And thank you guys again for using it. It means so much to me. And I'm having a lot of fun building it. We're having a lot of fun behind the scenes. Come get involved. There's a lot of interesting people involved with this. And yeah, it's exciting to see where this is going to go. Anyway, let's get into the video. If you can hear something walking around, that is this giant dog right here. Silver, say hello. Hello. You're so loud. You wanna be in the video? All right, what will we miss? Vsauce. Let's do it.
Hey, Vsauce, Michael here. And the year 6009 will be the very first year since 1961 that a year, when written in Hindu Arabic numerals, can be inverted and still look the same. But you and I probably won't live long enough to enjoy the year 6009. Human lives just aren't long enough. We will miss out on that. What other cool future events will we be missing? Well, first of all, you and I will probably be gone before the completion of the Time Pyramid in Vinding, Germany. It will eventually be a pile of 120 concrete blocks, but the builders are only adding one block every 10 years. Since beginning in 1993, they've added only the first three. At this rate, the pyramid will be completed in the year 3183, the final block placed by our great more than 30 greats grandchildren. But even they will miss an opportunity to frolic and play safely in the Chernobyl exclusion zone. The zone of—
I was just thinking, maybe, you know, I'll comment on the science of some of these, but I can also give you some of the things, you know, I'm annoyed that I'm gonna miss. There's definitely a lot of them. I've thought about this many times in my life. There's so many things I'm like, ugh, you know, that bums me that I'm gonna annoy that. But he's about to talk about Chernobyl. The last two videos we've talked about nuclear waste, nuclear energy, and nuclear bombs. Go check out those if you want to hear more about that. Sorry.
Of alienation, where radioactive contamination from the 1986 disaster remain at levels too high for safe human activity.
That looks like a mission out of Call of Duty 4. Now, anyone else see this? You know, that sniper mission.
For safe human activity until not the year 4000. Not the 5000s, not the 6000s, it will finally be safe probably in the year 22,000. Possibly within our lifetimes, but definitely within the next 1 million years, stars like Betelgeuse and Eta Carinae will explode in brilliant supernovas visible from Earth. I'm bummed I'm probably going to miss out on these events because for a few weeks it will look almost as if Earth has two suns. Despite being hundreds, thousands of light years away, their supernovas will shine brighter than the full moon at night and be visible even during daytime. But the real sky show—
it certainly won't look like another sun, but everything else he said is pretty, yeah, that's what we're thinking.
Show comes in 3.75 billion years. Our galaxy is full of stars. Viewed from the surface of the Earth, they look like little drops of milk in the sky, which is why we call it the Milky Way Galaxy. But all galaxies are named after milk. Milk, lactose, lactic, galactic, galaxies. And every drop of milk in the sky, every star that you can see, is inside our galaxy, the Milky Way. But there's a blurry, distant shape, this one. It's not a star, It's not a cloud of gas in our galaxy. It is an entirely different galaxy, the Andromeda Galaxy.
There's also the large and small Magellanic Clouds, but we'll
And it's 2.5 million light years away from our own. It contains twice as many stars as the Milky Way, and it is coming our way, headed toward us at 300 kilometers a second, faster than a bullet. Now, right now,
If you didn't get from what he's saying, yes, galaxies are really like islands floating in an ocean, and between the islands, yes, not much at all.
Sky looks like this. In 2 billion years, Andromeda will have approached so closely that people will look up at the sky and see this. In 3.75 billion years, the night sky will be like a scene from a science fiction movie or an awesome desktop wallpaper. Incredible. And kind of scary. After this scene, the sky will literally be glowing with the birth of new stars as the Milky Way and Andromeda collide, mixing up into a brilliant cosmic tie-dye. This simulation shows how Andromeda might collide with the Milky Way, but keep in mind that you are watching billions of years pass every second. These galaxies are moving fast, but they're also huge and covering even huger distances. They will collide in the future, but within the briefness of a single human life, they appear almost frozen, unmoving. A couple billion years after colliding, the cores of both galaxies will be married together in a bright glowing center. Earth, now a stepchild to what was once Andromeda, part of a new, bigger family called Milkdromeda. It would be so cool to be alive to see our galaxy colliding with another. But don't get all FOMO, consumed by a fear of missing out. Because whatever life is around then will have plenty to envy us for. They may have spectacular nightly views, but secretly wish they'd been born in our time to experience, say, the beginning of the internet. They will actually miss out on a lot of things. Because the moon moves 1 centimeter further away from Earth every year, 600 million years from today, the moon will no longer be close enough to Earth to completely block out the sun. Future humans, or descendants of humans, will therefore miss out on a chance to ever see for themselves the beauty of a total solar eclipse from the surface of Earth.
If you've seen the other moon videos I've made, you'd know that the moon, yes, whilst it's migrating away from the Earth, eventually it'll actually start coming back. So, yeah. And then eventually Earth might even destroy the moon because it might get a little bit too close and Earth's gravity is just going to rip it apart. So, yeah, go look into that. It's pretty exciting. So, but, you know, this stuff, you know, we'll never see another lunar eclipse if... How do you know the people by then won't be able to, just sail across the stars to another distant world or, you know, recreate everything in a simulation? Obviously, what I'm saying right now could be a counter to all of these things, you know, because a lot of these are in the far future. But let's just, you know, enjoy the romanticism of all this. And I'll give you some of my things shortly as well.
Long before Earth dries up, Niagara Falls will dry up. Well, not the water part, but the falls part. Every year, the rushing water of Niagara erodes the rock at the top of the falls 1 foot backward. By the year 52,000, it will have eroded all the way to Lake Erie, and our progeny will have no Niagara Falls to enjoy. Granite has an erosion rate of about 1 inch per 10,000 years. So, certainly by the year 7 million, Mount Rushmore, especially its faces, will no longer exist. And because they slowly get pulled in or ejected into space, in 50 to 100 million years, Saturn will no longer have its lovely rings. So, life on Earth in the future might have awesome supernovas and galactic collisions to look forward to, but they probably won't have Niagara Falls, Mount Rushmore, total solar eclipses, or Saturn's rings. They also won't have you. But you have you. Except not all of it. Babies don't begin to form episodic memories right away, meaning that you missed out on. You don't remember two of the most seminal events in your life, your conception and your birth. But you can experience a bit of those moments right now. First of all, when was I conceived.com lets you enter your birth date and get back the week your parents probably made you happen. This as well as the number one song and the number one movie of that week,
so
which may have also been involved. Life travels quickly, the most quickest, in fact, but it can take a photon millions of years to escape from the interior of the star it was created in through nuclear fusion. It takes time, just like your own gestation in your mother's womb. Newly conceived photons struggle through a dense stellar jungle of atoms and molecules and electrons that absorb and re-emit the photon, taking a little bit of energy from it as it randomly rolls around like a pinball. Sometimes, after thousands or millions of years, its random walk finally leads it to the star's surface, where it pops out into space.
Yeah, well, luckily for them, they don't experience time, and they're everywhere and anywhere, and they also don't experience distance.
In a way, is born. A lucky tiny, tiny, tiny percentage of the photons that reach the surface of a star find themselves on a path that will intersect with Earth. And if you are lucky, those photons will end their journey by being absorbed onto your own retina. If you enter the date of your birth, or the approximate date of your conception, into this online calculator, you can find a star that is as many light years away from Earth as you are old. When you look up at that star today, you are seeing light that left the star the very month you were born.
Or photons that
left that star and entered space when your entire body was just one cell. Space is really big, and your life is very short, but space is so gosh darn don't have to miss out on everything. And as always, thanks for watching.
All right, so some of the things I am annoyed that I'm gonna miss. There's a lot, all right? There's a huge list I've got for God, if there is one. I'm gonna be like, get me back in there, mate. Right, you know, these points, send me back, get me off the bench, gotta see it. You know, unfortunately, there might not be one. Okay, so some of the things I'd love to be around when, you know, we discover other life, you know, just simple life, and as well as intelligent life. If we do, it's possible we'll never get there. I think it's definitely around, and I think even simple life in our solar system will be found very soon. What else is there? Obviously, AGI, that would be awesome to be around. True artificial intelligence, that would be so cool. Could be our doom, might not. I don't think we can really say right now. You know, we'll shed our biological meat checks eventually. Love to be around for that. That's obviously very speculative. Obviously, the end of the universe looks like it could be a possibility. That would be very cool. I'd love to be around to see us travel to other stars. That's probably one of the most sentimental ones for me. As a boy, I used to like think about that a lot. Like, I just wish we could travel to other star systems right now to see what is out there. True adventure, right? Like, imagine living on Earth back in the day when we didn't even have complete maps of the world, and you could get on a ship and just like go discover. That would have been so awesome. You know, the next big adventure is going to see what else is out there in the universe. Let's go see other worlds, because they're just going to be beyond our imagination. Nature's imagination far exceeds ours. We are nature as well, obviously. Some of the more nerdy things, I'd love to be around to see what the next big pillar of physics is. You know, like, what's going to replace space-time? What's going to, the next big idea of gravity and everything else? I want to know what the hell's going on. That's what I want to be around when, if we figure out, like, what is this? Like, is this a simulation? Like, what is going on? Why are we here? Because obviously there's something going on, you know? Like, what? It's just so bizarre. I think that'll do for today's video, guys. Otherwise, we're going to be here all night. So, you know, come download Kel VPN, the alpha, and use it for free. It would help me out a lot. And it would mean the world. So, catch you guys next time.